Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. This is Lesson Waltz, second lesson of Waltz, Waltz number two. We're gonna get an underarm turn going into you. My name's Michael Scoggins. I'm with Ohio Ballroom Studios. I'm here at Oxford Community Arts Center in this wonderful, awesome ballroom. Guys should come out and check it out sometime. Oxford Community Arts Center does a lot of events and has theater going on and everything. So you should come check out Oxford Community Arts Center. I'm here on Thursday nights teaching ballroom classes every Thursday except for holidays. Anyway, so now we're going to the waltz lesson number two. I'd like to introduce my partner, Leah. Now, one thing to keep in mind, Leah's always going to be doing the girl's side. I am always going to be doing the guy's side. So we're not switching up or anything like that. Now you know who to watch in which direction. Last lesson, we went over the basic waltz, which was step, diagonal, switch feet, step, diagonal, switch feet. We also matched it with music. Pa, 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 pa. And we also counted it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. The numbers are gonna come in important now as we do an underarm turn. Can we do an underarm turn? No music, let's do that first. So, pa, 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 pa. That is what we're going to work towards, is an underarm turn. It's a six count underarm turn. Now, gentlemen, I wanna go over the footwork patterns or the upper body. Let me do the upper body first because I have that frame. Don't forget your tequila. Remember, first few lessons of waltz, you're gonna droop those arms and things aren't gonna function. Things will foul up real fast. So you gotta have your arms up, you gotta have that frame, and you gotta practice keeping this up. As I'm doing my waltz, you take a look at my upper body's not doing anything. It's just right there. And it's kind of held and it's a little bit stiff, but not too hard. Now, code words for an underarm turn. 1, 2, 3. Raise, push her through. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. So raise is, my left hand goes up, raise, push her through. Now when I say push, because I'm raising and I'm opening a doorway for the girl to go through, so she knows something's coming up. Push is not fast. It's not fast. It is gentle. However, it is insistent. Gotta push on the girl so that she cannot stay here. Because if you don't push on the girl, she's gonna stay here. So each hand has a job. Raise, push her through. Okay, push her through. These are happening at separate times. Raise, push. Okay, not at the same time. Raise, push. That doesn't work. That doesn't work. So raise, push. Now watch this from the back side. I'm going 1, 2, 3. Raise, push her through. Step, diagonal, switch feet. Step, diagonal, switch feet. And you just keep going with that footwork. Once you push her through, you just think about your footwork. Don't match her footwork. Don't look at her footwork. Don't care. That's her job and you can't help her. And if you are overly concerned, one of the things I find with new students is that the lead or the male gets overly concerned with the his follow's part and then can't focus on his own and it doesn't work. So once you push her through, everything goes to step, diagonal, switch feet, step, diagonal, switch feet. You don't even have to worry about recapturing her into frame. She will magically appear right in front of you and you just go whoop whenever you're ready and you're good to go. You're good to go. So all your thought goes step, diagonal, switch feet. We're gonna do that about 2-3 times. Do that with me, do that with me. So here we go, men. And step, diagonal, switch feet, raise, push through, step, diagonal, switch feet, step, diagonal, switch feet. Now, I think I used some different code words, so I'm sorry. I really want you to go 1, 2, 3, step diagonal switch feet. 1, 2, 3, raise, push her through. Step diagonal switch feet. Sorry about that. Here we go. Men, let's do it together again a couple times. And 1, 2, 3, raise, push through. Step diagonal switch feet. Step diagonal switch feet. Step diagonal switch feet. Again, here we go. And 1, 2, 3, raise, push through, step diagonal switch feet, step diagonal switch feet, step diagonal switch feet, step diagonal switch feet. One last time, men. Here we go. Ready? And 1, 2, 3, raise, push through, step diagonal switch feet, step diagonal switch feet, step diagonal switch feet, step diagonal switch feet. Okay, men. Now, I want you to go somewhere else and I want you to practice that and literally do it about 10 times. Don't think you got it after about 3 times. It gets a little bit more complex when you get a partner in your hand. Things begin to change. So what I want you to do, gentlemen, go do that. Don't listen to the girls' part, okay, because it'll only confuse you. I only want you focusing on your part. And remember, after the raise, push her through, do the footwork. Step, diagonal, switch feet. That's your job. That's your job. Okay, now Leah's going to demonstrate the lady side. Do, 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 do. Now, one of the things is she is going to do walk in a circle for 6 counts, but she's going to do a box for 1, 2, 3, 4. And then she walks in a circle. Okay, so watch this, and let's just go ahead and demonstrate that, if you could please, Leah. Ready? And 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Basic box. 3, 4, 5, 6. Sorry, I went a little bit further than that. All right, so it is important to note, now the fourth footfall is the placement. If you're doing a box, number 4 is the same placement as if you're doing a basic, ladies, or an underarm turn. That foot goes straight at the guy. I want you to do one, Leah, do 1, 2, 3, 4 of the basic. Watch this, ladies. Ready? And 1, 2, 3, stop, 4. There's 4. That's a basic box. Do the same thing again, but now you're doing an underarm turn. Ready? And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You notice that footfall number 4 was in the same place. And I want to get in there, and there's a reason for that, ladies. The reason being is that your footfall number 4, you step straight forward at the guy. 1, 2, 3, 4. So you see how Leah's stepping forward. If she's already started the underarm turn, she's going to clip this foot. She's going to trip herself over that foot. So this is 1, 2, 3, and then I restart the count. And go ahead. That was 1, 2, 3, and then I restart the count for the ladies. And then you count 6. So you'll hear 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, basic 2, 3. And basic is just step diagonal switch feet. So watch Leah's foot, get ready to join Leah in her footwork. Ready and go. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Box 2, 3. Basic box. Now, it is very important to note that Leah is walking in a circle. Just walk in a circle, Leah. Okay, see how each footfall is going forward. If you've done the swing videos, keep walking in a circle if you could. If you've done the swing videos, the rock step will cause a lady to cross behind herself, but this is the waltz. Can you cross behind yourself when you're ready? See how she crossed behind herself there? That's gonna mess you up, ladies. Do not cross behind yourself. It is walking in a circle around a trash can. That's basically what you're thinking. I'm walking, there's a trash can right there. She's walking in a circle around it. It is too easy, and your mind may try to overcomplicate it. So let's do it a couple times, and ladies, I want you to follow along with Leah. Here we go. And 1, two, three. One, two, three, four, five, six. Box, two, three. Here we go again. And one, two, three. One, two, three, four, five, six. Box, two, three. Now, do it one more time, Leah. Here we go. And one, two, three, four, five. Oops, sorry, I messed up. Reset, do it again. I messed up my word and my counting. Boy, here we go. And one, two, three. One, two, three, four, five, six. Box, two, three. Now, can you demonstrate, Leah, a spin out right there, a circle that is too small? So, ladies, one of the big things is that a tendency for the ladies is to make the circle too small. So watch this one. She's going to be right on top of her partner. I'm going to jump in there, and you'll see how close she is to me. At that point, I can't continue doing the basic. Now I'm going to do it again, and she's going to take a normal circular size. So, it is important, ladies, that you take a nice size circle on that. Now, the other thing is that I want to demonstrate with you, Leah, is that, other thing that I want to demonstrate here is that you do not have to be back together, holding on to each other in frame to begin the box. You don't have to be. So in this one, Leah, I want to do this one, and I want to end far away from each other. And you'll notice that we keep doing the basic, and later on, I just kind of sneak us and pull us back together to get back in the frame. So if you'll please, come on this side. So notice that we just kept going. We just kept dancing. You don't have to be right on top of each other. The first few times you do it, if you're further away, it's a little bit advantageous than being right on top of each other. So that is a waltz underarm turn. Gentlemen, get your guy. You can, ladies, holler for your guy. He can come back now. And we're going to demonstrate just an underarm turn. With some music. Here we go. All right, ladies and gentlemen, you have learned how to do an underarm turn in the waltz, and it's pretty cool. And you're discovering that the secrets to ballroom are not that complicated. Once you understand the sequence or the secrets, and you go through the sequence a few times, then you begin to latch on and you say, oh yeah, I got this. This is not that tricky. And it's a lot of fun. You're gonna love learning about ballroom. Once again, I'm Michael Scoggins, Ohio Ballroom Studios at Oxford Community Arts Center. Thank you, Oxford Community Arts Center. And thank you to Leah. Please come out and take a quick bow, Leah. There we go. There we go. Remember that we're here every Thursday night teaching ballroom classes. Get in contact with us for classes on Thursday nights. You can contact Oxford Community Arts Center, or you can contact me at ohioballroom.com. Now, the other thing is that we're going to be putting lists of music out there for you so that you can go to YouTube and have music to practice with. Remember, have fun. That's why ballroom exists, for fun. Thank you very much.